Hello everyone and welcome back to the channel. Today I'm going to be featuring a game that I haven't played in many years, which is Cold Waters. And in particular we're going to look at a mod called Dot Mod that introduces surface ships into the game. And if you're new to the channel and you don't know my history, I started out actually as playing a lot of naval games. In particular, like strategy games in naval games, as well as Cold Waters. I dabbled in it back in the day. And then, you know, most recently I've been featuring a lot of Flight Simulator, DCS and such. So, you know, my passions have always been aircraft, ships, and space games. So today I'm gonna look back at this game. And in particular, I want to demonstrate what modern warfare looks like in the missile age. So I'm gonna discuss it as I go along here. But essentially, I'm gonna pick a Udaloy as my adversary and do a 1v1. And I'm gonna take an Ali Burr class guided missile destroyer from the U.S. against it. And the thing that I noticed right away is that there is a imbalance between the U.S. Navy ships and the Russian ships. In particular, I think it has to do with the limitation of the mod. What essentially happens is that the Russian ships have like a reload time on some of their surface-to-air missiles, whereas the American ships don't. Even, for example, the Perry-class frigate has a, you know, like a single launcher, like an outdated Mark 13, and it's supposed to have like an 8-second reload, but you can shoot those things like a machine gun. So, anyways, the reason why I chose the Udaloy is because as it says here, it's a large anti-submarine ship. It's not meant to be like, its strengths are anti-submarine warfare and anti-air warfare. Not crazy anti-air, just it's got these Kinzel SAMs, or they're like SSN 9s, I think. And essentially, they shoot out of these tubes here, these four tubes here, and these four tubes here. Short to medium range missiles, but they are pretty effective against incoming anti-ship missiles. And then here in these 8 launcher, it's got these Rastrov B missiles, or SSN-14s, which shoot a missile that has a torpedo underneath it. It's a dual purpose missile. When you shoot it against a ship, it basically has a relatively small warhead, but it's just got 8 of those. So what it's going to try to do is shoot 8 of these at me, and then that's it. It's got not much, and it's going to try to shoot guns because we're going to be within gun range. And I will demonstrate basically how easy it is for an Arleigh Burke to defend against these, and then see what it takes to actually take this thing out as far as missiles. So as you can see here, it's got the Kinzel, it's got the anti-missile defense system, which is basically these AK-630 close-in weapon systems. I think it's I want to say it's hard to zoom in, but I'm pretty sure we'll see when we get into the game. I can't quite tell. I think it's these guys right here. Yeah, it's got 1, 2, 3, 4. I think it's got 4 of them. They're pretty good. And the rest of it, you know, torpedoes and stuff. But so let's go quickly. I'll show you the Arleigh Burke that I'm going to take. I'm just going to take a Flight 1 Arleigh Burke. You know, it's got 32 vertical launch system tubes in the front. And it's got something like 64 in the back. And it's got 8 harpoons. And it's got these standard missiles, which can be used against primarily it's air defense SAM, but they're dual purpose and can be used against ships. And that's the real advantage of these American ships is, besides the Kirov on the Russian side, these ships can actually, they have a ton of missiles they can throw at the enemy ships. So let's get going and let's accept this. What I'm gonna do is get rid of my Azeroths. These are anti-submarine rockets that launch like a torpedo at distance. We don't need them. And then I'm gonna get rid of our Tomahawk line, get the attack missiles, which are cruise missiles for attacking land targets, which we're not gonna do. And I'm gonna pile up on these RIM 66s, standard missiles, ones or twos, I guess. 73 of those, plus 20 of them in this area, plus 8 Tomahawks. So, crap load of missiles. But, anyways, let's get going.
Let's zone our new contact bearing 284, designated Sierra 1.
So, that's what she looks like. Here's our torpedo tubes, here's the harpoons. Here's there's a 1C was in the back, 1C was in the front. 5-inch gun. And the VLSs that I talked about. Alright. What we're gonna do is we got a sonar contact, but we're just gonna raise all our masts. He's gonna detect us, and then we're gonna head back so we
come left
get some distance,
main
right?
Con so. Sonar. We are cavitating.
Yeah, don't care. Alright, so here we go. We got our standard missiles ready in anti-missile mode. We can shoot down helicopters. Alright, so here we go. So he is launching, I think he's launched two of these missiles, so they look like this. So what we're gonna do is counter with... bunch of those.
Fire VLS.
So let's take a look. Wow, that's not good actually. Let's start launching some chaff. We got two missiles inbound here. Because our sea was going there. Alright. I'm surprised that our standard missiles didn't do anything there. So what he's gonna do probably is gonna launch... I think he's... no, he's shooting us with his guns. But I think he's got a few more missiles there. I think he's only launched 4. So we'll see what about that. He's trying to shoot us with his guns, so that's why I wanna get, you know, get back there.
Con sonar, launch transient from.
Launch transient, sorry, I just wanna reduce this volume just a slight bit. Alright, launch transient, what do you launch? There you go. So here's a torpedo. It's got the boosters that come off. Let's see if our standard missiles can do a better job this time.
Con, torpedo fire, VLS, fire, VLS.
I fired 4 this time. Usually you don't need, you need 1 or 2, but...
Con, sonar, launch transient from.
Okay, let's see. So you can see our SM's standard missiles coming in.
Con, sonar, launch transient from.
Yeah, 4 of them. Let's see. Alright, there you go. And then we've got our other missiles going towards the second target here, and it's gone as well. And here's the third one. So this guy is pretty much out of missiles at this point. I'm pretty sure he doesn't have much left. He's still trying to shoot at us. And that's it, right? Like, we defended, he just couldn't get through. The first time with the Seawiz and now with the... So what we could do is launch some tomahawks, or sorry, some harpoons, which, oops, I didn't mean to do that, but anyway, they launch from here. So, let's launch 3 of them and see how this thing does against 3 of them. There she goes. They get close to the target and then they will skim close to the surface here. These are very slow missiles, very old technology at this point, compared to a lot of what the Russians and Chinese.
Con, sonar, launch transient from.
So this thing is now launching SAMs. There you go. So here's the SAM that it's launched. You can see it's a very small, very small SAM. Oh, it got it. Look at that. Oh, what the hell? Okay, that's not good. Yeah, you see our Tomahawks are not doing very well. Alright, let's try to fix this. Torpedo room, what is that?
Damage control party, lead of the reactor space.
Alright. Let's try to not hit some freaking icebergs here. Holy cow. Let's do a full back turn here. Okay. Now that we did that, you know, you see that we saw a flight of four or three of these didn't do anything. Let's try another flight of four. And those are probably also not going to get through, but just to prove a point. Alright, I think, let's see, can we clear this turn? Probably not yet.
Con, sonar, launch transient from.
Alright, he's launching again. Let's see. Let's see, he's launching one at a time. This is not gonna look good for him. He did get one of them. You gotta launch more SAMs, buddy. Granted that he does have close-in weapon systems, which will... Okay, he's definitely launching missiles. He's got one there. Nope, didn't get it. That one's gonna hit.
Sonar lost contact. Master,
oh shit, he's done. Alright. So much for the Eudaloid SAM. I don't know what happened there. Well, that was disappointing. Sinking him with four harpoons. Okay. Let's try this with a bit more challenge. By the way, this is on highest difficulty setting, so alright, let's go here. And the Udala is a good should we add two of them or should we add a Sovereign and me? Let's do two Udalas. Okay, we'll do two of them. And we'll make sure they're aggressive, and then what we'll do is grab a this guy here. So now we're gonna go against two of them. I do need to get rid of these as we did last time. And the Tomahawks, get rid of those, they're useless, and then load up on SMs. So the trick here is going to be to survive their first volley, because they're both going to launch at me. And
we're
going to have to go from there.
1-5-0.
Ops go.
Okay. So they're right here. We're going to head
left to 3.
Head away from them.
Big turns for 3-4 knots. Mincon sonar, we are cavitating.
I'm going to get ready to defend here with these SAMs. Okay, so
sonar, launch transient from.
Launch transient, alright.
Con sonar, launch transient from.
Le- let's launch two.
Fire VTON sonar. Launch transient from. Fire VLS.
Alright, so I think they launched three.
Con sonar. Launch transient from. Con sonar. Launch transient from. Fire VLS.
So I'm doing like two per missile here. Okay, so they're shooting these
Con sonar, launch transient from. Con sonar, launch transient from.
Because you were taking that one pretty convincingly.
Fire VLS, fire VLS.
I'm shooting two per missile.
Con sonar, launch transient from.
And
Con maneuvering,
you know,
three. Con sonar,
wow, we're really taking them out. Let's see, we got three missiles going for this guy. He's dead. Yep, took them all out. Wow.
Con sonar, launch transient from. Fire VLS.
Like, they're not even making it past. Okay, let's try not to hit any ice here. Let's head in that direction right there. Alright, so I sent another two standard missiles at this guy. Boom. There he goes. So these guys should be pretty much out of these the 8 packs of the SSN-14. Oh, there he goes. Alright, I'm gonna let that one come in a bit closer. I'm gonna launch just one, because I am probably getting close to running out. Oh, 54 left. Okay, no, maybe not. I'm gonna just. Oh, what happened there? Interesting. So they look like they're not launching anymore. Alright, so what I'm going to do is, we saw that four of these sank a Udaloy, but okay, looks like we're going to defend again one more. Alright, let's get another one for this guy. They must be running out, there's like not much left here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to shoot what do you call it? Harpoons. And I'm gonna do a volley of like, probably all this volley, because they have like twice the SAMs, and they have pretty good SAMs. So this whole volley of 8 harpoons will probably barely hit. I'm expecting one hit on one of these Udaloys, maybe two. So where's the other guy? So there they are. This guy gonna hit something.
Con okay. Sonar, launch transient from.
So they're defending. Looks like they got a couple of
Con
missiles.
Sonar, launch transient from.
Oh, this is not looking good for this guy. Not looking good at all. This guy is pretty much dead, I think. Look at that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Con
sonar. So we got two SAMs, two sets of SAMs trying to hit here. Here it is. This guy is tracked. Here comes the probably. He's launching chaff or flares. And he got hit. He's pretty much hit multiple times, actually. Yep, pretty much dead. So, took about 5 or 6 harpoons, and this guy is pretty much sinking. So that's the harpoons. Well, very cool how this guy is turning. Alright, so what we're gonna do now is look at the effectiveness of surface to these standard missiles. So you see this little icon here, it's set to anti-missile. We're gonna go ahead and shoot
VLS, fire VLS, fire VLS.
Four of them, see how that works. The SAMs are, standard missiles are much faster. But they have smaller warheads, you know, and they don't do as much damage.
Con sonar, launch trans in from.
Okay, so this guy is launched. Oh, that's a nice view.
Con sonar, launch trans in from.
Alright, never mind. Freaking dead. Oh, this is way too easy. So yeah, I sent four standard missiles at this guy, and I mean, he's still rolling. Got a big ass hole. But it made it through. Which. Just to continue our test here, so four of them went through, so let's say we do two. Anti-ship. Let's do three. So four went through. Let's see if three will get through. There we are. I can probably slow down a bit.
Launch trans in from.
There's Sam. Look at how small this thing is.
Maneuvering,
not very big, but they can fire a lot of them. He should be firing a lot more. Ooh. Nice. Don't think he got hit. I mean, still has a giant hole from the previous volley. But he's still hanging in there. So, good. So it looks like he can defend against three. What if I stagger them? And then staggered another two, so make it easier on them. So we're still gonna do four, because three of them didn't get through at all. Four did last time. There he goes. And they launch from here, you see? Here and here. Alright. Let's see. Nice. Two more coming in. Nope. He got hit. Took down three of them, but one of them got hit by one. Guy's leaking oil. There's the other hole. Got two holes now. But you can see these standard missiles, you know, they could potentially be repaired. Don't do as much damage. So just to finish this guy off, actually I was going to send a helicopter, but yeah, that's not going to work with these SAMs. Oh, this guy is still floating around. So, okay, let's finish her off.
Fire VLS. Fire VLS.
Three more. Should be it for this guy. Where's that missile going? Jesus.
Con sonar, launch trans.
Yep, he is
from.
Dead.
Con sonar, lost contact. Master,
there
two.
You go.
Last bearing, 1, 4, 7. Contact breaking up.
I don't know. Two usual easy pickings. Easy pickings. There you go. There you have it, guys. just a taste of what this mod looks like on with the surface ships. You know, you can also deploy the helicopters, and they can be useful for detection, you know, and as well as what do you call it? Anti-submarine warfare. They can shoot down. They can use torpedoes. That is pretty cool. Screenshot right there. Yeah, you can give them orders, you know, to go places. They got two of these, two torpedoes, and yeah, they can cause some havoc. Love the graphics. Love the graphics. Great game. If you're into naval games at all, love ships, and great game. Both the submarine aspect of it, which was available for a long time, and the surface mod. Really a lot of fun. Really a lot of fun. So, hope you guys enjoyed. And yeah, I'll try to do more of these. I think I will probably keep increasing the odds, and maybe looking at the Kirov, which is their most powerful ship. And yeah, continue testing this thing out. Thanks for watching, guys.